In this lecture, we are talking about what happens when you are compiling Solidity. What is it exactly that makes the blockchain running your smart contracts? So, in this lecture, we are talking about EVM assembly and opcodes. The Ethereum virtual machine cannot run Solidity directly. Instead, you are deploying bytecode, which is representing EVM assembly or opcodes. Let's say you want to develop a smart contract that can calculate the sum of A plus B. So you have a function sum, and that has two arguments, A and B. Something rather simple. Nothing is written to the blockchain, no variables, no advanced data structures. Let's have a look what really happens under the hood.
Here I'm again in Remix. I have a very short smart contract that basically adds two numbers and returns the result. You can find this example also in our course repository as file x2.solidity. If the contract gets compiled, then it will get translated to bytecode or opcodes. You can see that here in Remix when you click on the details. If we go ahead and create or deploy this contract, then this bytecode gets embedded into a transaction without a receiver address. You see here that the to field is empty. That means that a new smart contract will be deployed with the bytecode attached as input data payload. You can see this here when you open the transaction details. Now, what exactly happens when you are calling this function sum? Well, let's try. First of all, you get back the result of the function. But what happens internally? Let's dig a bit deeper and debug this transaction. First, let's look at the transaction itself. This transaction also has an input data payload. The first 4 bytes or 8 hex characters are the first few bytes of the KSAC hash of the function signature. That function signature would be the hash of sum u into 56, u into 56, but that's not important right now. The next 32 bytes or 64 hex characters are the padded input argument 5, and the next ones are the padded input argument 6. If we debug into this transaction, we can follow exactly what happens. It's basically a state machine running through assembly commands. Let's scroll back to the beginning. I'm highlighting now one element that is pushing the exact same 4 bytes of the hash of the function signature onto the stack and then comparing it with the first 4 bytes of the input data. If that equals, it will jump to a specific point in the code. And then it will run the opcodes that are there until it has reached a return or stop opcode.
Pretty exciting how this works under the hood. Your takeaway doesn't have to be in so much detail. Just remember, the EVM is basically a state machine that runs assembly and opcodes.